Hi guys, welcome back to another tutorial. In this video, I'll be showing you how to make a wide leg palazzo jumpsuit with side pleats. This video is long overdue because I dropped the introduction to making a jumpsuit previously, so I'm sorry that the video took so long. Let's get right into the video. You want to get your measurements right when you are making a jumpsuit. How well your jumpsuit turns out depends on your measurement as well as your pattern drafting. So making your jumpsuit, if you've not watched the part one of this jumpsuit video, I'll put it in the description box. You can watch it before you watch this video. In the previous video, I said jumpsuit is simply the combination of your high waist pants pattern and your basic bodies. So now you're going to tie the higher part of your waist. It's cuter when your pants for your jumpsuit start from the high waist. You can do low waist if you prefer your jumpsuit trouser to start from the low waist. I hope you get what I mean. So now you're going to tie that high waist part of your waist, the softest part of your waist, and then measure from the highest part of your shoulder to where you tied. Whatever you get, you can put it, write it down, and then for your back, you measure from your nape to where the rope is. So if you do this correctly, you will see that your front body's measurements will be bigger than your back body's measurement because of your bust. So you want to take note of that when you are making a jumpsuit. Now the next thing you want to measure is the length of the jumpsuit. So from where you have tied now, you are now going to measure the length of your jumpsuit so that whatever you get, you are going to add it to the upper part. I hope you understand. It's very simple. It's basic. Just go to the previous video I did. I explained it in details there. And then to get your crotch depth, you just pick a chair, sit down on it where you tie, so don't remove that rope, and just measure from there. If you get this measurement accurately, you don't need to be adding anything, plus one when you are drafting your pattern or when you are cutting out the lower part of this outfit. Alternatively, you can do your hip divided by 4 plus 2 inches for the lower part. To get your crotch depth, if you are a small sized person, and if you are from size 10 and above, you can do +3 inches when you are making a jumpsuit. So now that we have cleared that out of the way, let's get into the tutorial proper. So I'm making use of 3 to 3.5 yards of black crepe fabric for this outfit, and then for the gray part, I used about 1/2 yard. I know I didn't use up to 1 yard for that part. Since we're using freehand for the lower part of this outfit, I'll be showing you another method of cutting a trouser. So we're putting it on fold. Remember, we are going with wide leg, a very wide pant now. So to place your material on fold, if you don't want to waste your material, what you want to do is divide your hip by 4. Whatever you get there, put it aside. Divide your hip again by 16 to get your crouch extension. Divide your hip by 4 first, put that aside. Divide your hip by 16, whatever you get, add it to that. And then we are adding 4 inches for ease, because this is going to be a very bogus trouser. So 4 inches is fine. You saw what I achieved with that. So if you know you want your own to be bigger, you can add. If you want your own to be smaller, you can make it of 2 inches or 3 inches. So you're going to add 4 inches as extra allowance, and then you're going to add 2 inches for sewing allowance, which is 1 inch on both sides. I hope I'm clear. Let me take it again just to be clear. You're going to divide your hip by 4. You're going to divide your hip by 16. Add that together, and then you're going to add 4 inches ease to make the outfit bogus, and then you are now going to add 2 inches sewing allowance to sew it on both sides. That's what you're going, whatever you get, that's what you're going to use to fold this material. The next thing we're going to do is mark our hem allowance from the edge of the fabric, just like we normally do when we're drafting our pants. For this one, I'm using 2 inches because I want enough material to fold in. Now that you've marked the hem allowance, you're going to start your measurements from this hem allowance. So what I'm going to do is, to get the length of this trouser, I'm going to simply subtract my upper body's measurement, or use the exact measurement I got when I measured from my waist down. That's what I'm going to use to cut this lower part. The reason why I'm using 60 here is because I started the measurement from my half length. So I measured from my half length. Whatever I got from my half length, I took it out of the tape, and I want the full length of this outfit to be 60 because I want it to touch the floor. So make use of the length you prefer. So now the next thing I'm going to do is mark out my hip measurement, my hip length. And my hip length is 9 inches. I'm going to mark out my crotch length that we got at the beginning of this video, which is 11 inches. Then the next thing I'm going to do is measure my crotch extension on these 3 lines, because now we have our waistline, our hip line, and our crotch line. It's just the basic way we make pants, just like my previous tutorial, but just a little bit different. So we are going to rule out that line. The mistake I made here, that's why I always advise that watch videos till the end before you do any tutorial, before you use any tutorial. I did not remember to leave the 1 inch here for sewing at this crotch extension. So instead of 2.5 inches, which I did there, I should have done 3.5. I don't know if you get what I mean, because now that the crotch, I did not add 1 inch to that crotch area. If you sew there, you're going to now make a mistake because your crotch area, your crotch extension will be too small. So make sure you don't make the same mistake I made. I corrected it after cutting. So the next thing you want to do is mark the midpoint on this your line, on this your crotch line here. Mark the midpoint. After you mark the midpoint, you're going to connect it to the upper part. You're going to connect the crotch extension. Then you can go ahead and cut. Remember that when you're cutting, you need to leave 1/2 inch at the crotch area and at the upper waist area for sewing. Now for this particular outfit, you're not going to shape in the waist. Your waist measurement and your hip measurement is going to be the same. It's going to just be straight since we are pleating it. What we're going to do is remove the part for our pocket. And for pocket, you just simply measure 7 inches from your waist point, from your waistline, and then come in by 1.5 inch or 2 inches if you want your pocket to show, and cut it out. Now this place, now where we made mistake before, is what I'm going to correct. I told you I left the exact crotch extension instead of adding 1 inch for sewing allowance. That's for our seam allowance. So I'm correcting it here. I'm just adding the 1 inch and reshaping that crotch area. So nothing different, just the same method, but I'm adding the 1 inch allowance for sewing that I forgot to add before. So try not to make the same mistake. I'm just curving the crotch area again to get the shape. Don't forget to leave 1/2 inch at that place that you're going to use to join. So we're done with the front of this pants. We're not going to cut the back. For the back, now this is where it's going to be a little bit different from the previous tutorial I did. At this crotch extension area, you want to increase it by 2 inches if you are a small size person, maybe from size 10 and below. But if you are from size 10 and above, you want to work with up to 2.5 to 3 inches crotch extension for the back. So I'm just marking 2 inches all around this crotch extension, and then I'm going to connect everything to form our crotch curve. But now the difference between this front and back is that your back should be slanted so that you're going to avoid any unnecessary bulge. So I'm just coming in by 1 inch at that upper part and connecting it down so that I'll have a slanted crotch curve for the back. When you're done, don't forget to cancel out the previous line you have so that you will not get confused when you're cutting. Now the next thing I want to do is measure what you have on the hip line and waistline of your front area and transfer it to the back. Now from this, our new crotch line, and then at the waist area for the back, just come up by 1/2 inch. Very small, 1/2 inch or 1 inch. It should not be too much compared to when you are making a normal pant. You can do up to 1.5 inches, but 1/2 inch or 1 inch is just fine to raise, and then you connect the line. Next thing you want to do is give your zipper allowance. You want to measure 10 inches length and then come out by 1 inch and just connect that curve to form your zipper allowance, and then you can go ahead and cut. Now we have our front part and we have our back pattern. For the pocket, the best measurement for the pocket is 7 inches wide and 12 inches length. That's the best size of pocket that will be very comfortable to do. So I'm cutting on fold because I'm cutting the two pockets at once, and then you want to leave 1/2 inch and 1 inch by the side for your seam allowance. That's for your sewing allowance and to close up the under. Then I'm going to place it on my front pattern and just trim out the pocket. This part now that we're doing, I explained it more in detail in the previous pants tutorials that I dropped on this channel. You can check them out for more clarity. So after fixing the pocket, I'm just going to pin down the two front parts together and sew that crotch area by 1/2 inch. Remember, we left 1/2 inch for sewing allowance, so I'm going to use that 1/2 inch to sew. And then for the back part also, I'm going to join the two backs together and I'm going to use 1/2 inch to sew and stop at where the zipper is going to start from. That's it for the lower part of this outfit. Now for the upper part, we're just basically drafting our basic bodies. I have a basic bodies tutorial on this channel. You can check it out for more clarity. But I'm drafting the normal basic bodies. But the difference is that we're using our front measurement to draft the length of the front and the back measurement to draft for the length of the back. So now this basic bodies I'm drafting has a length of 17 inches while my back has a length of 15 inches. I'm just going to show you how to maneuver your way and manipulate the darts to make sure you get it accurate. I'm just redoing this basic bodies tutorial for those that probably have not watched the previous video on my basic bodies pattern. But I believe if you are trying to learn how to sew a jumpsuit, then definitely you would know how to draft the basic bodies. What I'm just doing is I'm marking out my chest line, I'm marking out my bust line and my waistline. That's all I need for my basic bodies tutorial. And then I'm marking out where my dart is going to be. I'm taking half an inch on both sides for my dart, and I'm just going ahead to connect everything. But now, because our front bodies is longer than the back, you want to subtract the back length from the front length, and whatever you get, you are going to use to form your bust dart. So what you do is that you do your front length minus your back length, and whatever you get, you are going to come down from your bust line with that particular number and connect it to the nipple point, just like I did. That's how we get our bust dart. Now, you will now notice that after drafting your back pattern, if you place your back pattern on this, your front pattern, you'll see that it is longer. The front pattern is longer than the back. So what you want to do is slash your dart for your front pattern and then close up this bust dart, just the way I'm doing, and then rule out the line again just to make sure it's straight. And that's what you have. This is it. If you put this back now on the front, you will see that it is the same length for the side, and that's what we're trying to achieve. The reason why we are doing this is because if you use the same measurement for back and front, when you are done, except the fabric is a very stretchy fabric, when you are done, you will see that the back will start having zip bulge, unnecessary zip bulge. And I feel like that's like the major problem for most people that make jumpsuit, is the back zip area having like bulge or the crouch area. Those are the two most important places. So take notes of it. If you know you want to draft out the front and back the same length, then you now know that you have to maneuver and manipulate the back that area to make sure the back length is shorter than the front length. I hope you get what I mean. So you can go ahead and use your normal basic bodies to make your jumpsuit, but I am just creating my own style. I'm creating my own design out of it. I just decided to think of something unique to make. That's why I'm cutting out the upper part and doing that for the back, because I want this jumpsuit to have two colors, which is gray and black, like you saw at the beginning. So whichever way you want to maneuver or manipulate your basic bodies pattern to form the style you want, you can go ahead and do that. Now, after you have your front and back, you want to go ahead and cut your sleeve. I also have a sleeve tutorial. You can check it out on my channel. Now I'm going to use this pattern that I've cut now to cut out on my fabric. So when you open your dart wide like this, you want to take note of how to cut it exactly the way I'm doing it. When you get to that area, you're going to bring it out a bit. If you know you are going to sew that, because it's very wide, I'm going to cut my own out. So if you follow the way I'm doing it, it's going to be very easy for you. I'm just leaving 1 inch side seam allowance, and then for the middle, I decided to just cut out that, so that I'm not going to have any bogus dart in the outfit. So I'm going to use this half an inch left to join the darts together for this front. I'm doing the same thing for the back, leaving 1 inch at the side for sewing allowance, half an inch at the lower part for joining to the trouser part, 1 inch for the zipper allowance, and the upper part also half an inch. Make sure you're cutting your allowances and everything is accurate, because if it is not, you're going to start seeing discrepancies when you make the jumpsuit. So for the upper part of the front, that's my yoke part, I'm using a gray fabric. So I'm just cutting it out. I'm leaving half an inch all through for plus the neck area and everywhere. And then I'll go ahead and also cut a facing for this. So this particular one, if you're making this particular style, you want to cut that one in two pieces so that you can use one to turn one over. Then I'm doing the same thing for the back pattern. So now we have everything ready. If you are following the tutorial, that means you've already joined this front and back part of the trouser together. The next thing we're going to do now, after joining the pieces together, I'm going to join the front and back together at the crotch area. When you are joining, make sure you use a pin. No matter how good you are, using a pin is actually important. So you want to pin down the crotch area first, pin it all through, and then you want to pin down the side area. So I normally like to start sewing from my crotch area down before I join the side together. Now that I've done this, I'm now going to join the upper part to the lower part. I've sewn the upper part, I've sewn the lower part. It's now time to join the upper part to the lower part to create our jumpsuit. Now for the trouser part, since the waist area is way bigger than the waist of the top, I'm going to make sure I make them equal. And I just want to have one pleat at the two sides of the bag. That's one pleat at the left side, another pleat at the right side, and the same thing for the front. So what I'm going to do is that from the midpoint, that after you've calculated whatever you are putting for your zipper allowance, from that midpoint, calculate your natural waist divided by 4. So if your waist is 24 divided by 4, it's going to be 6 inches. You're going to calculate that 6 inches from the midpoint, and then you pleat whatever you have to the side seam. That way you are going to have a correct waist measurement. I hope you understand. So from the midpoint of the front also, you're going to measure 6 inches. If 6 inches is quarter of your waist, you're going to measure that 6 inches, and then you're going to pleat whatever is left to the side seam, so that all the pleats is going to go into the side seam, and you're going to have an accurate waist measurement. I hope you understand. So from the center front and center back, calculate your original waist divided by 4, and then pleat whatever you have left, no matter the amount, to the side seam. That way your waist is going to be perfect and accurate, and then you can go ahead and pin it down to your top. Make sure all the seams are meeting the correct seams for the top, and go ahead and sew. When you are done, this is what it's going to look like. I always emphasize, make sure you iron, press it well. So make sure you press down your seams and everywhere when you are done. Now the next thing we're going to do is fix our zipper, and my previous videos I've talked about it many times, how to fix your zipper. Make sure you pin down your zipper before you fix it. If you follow this tutorial word for word, you're not going to have any issue with zip bulge, because we've already eliminated that right from the pattern drafting. So after fixing your zip, I went ahead to fix the hand, that's the sleeve area. I went ahead to fix the sleeve area. If you are making something exactly like this and you want the sleeve part to match, you can measure whatever you have on that gray area and make sure it matches the measurement on your sleeve. That's it, very simple. When you are done with it, you can sew the hem of your pants. You can either use hem gum to glue it down first before you take it to your machine, or just sew it directly, whichever one you want. But yeah, that is it. It's very, very simple, very easy. When you are done with this, you are not going to have any issue with crouch measurement if you did it correctly. Pretty sure everything is going to be perfect. So if you found this video helpful, don't forget to give the video a big thumbs up. Don't forget to share to others. It may be helpful to drop a lovely comment and subscribe, most importantly. So if you have questions or video request, you can also drop it in the comment section. For those that tried out my last pants tutorials and went ahead to send me pictures and videos of their results, I see you guys and I love you guys so much. So let me know if you're going to try this out, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you get notifications when I post another tutorial. And also don't forget to drop your tutorial request. See you in my next video. Until then, keep winning.